For those of you guys interested, this is my homemade spray booth that I'm making. I just simply started with a roughneck brand plastic storage bucket. And as you can see, I cut out three holes in the bottom of it for three fans. Those are 120 millimeter server fans. Those aren't normal computer PC fans, they're server fans. They're rated at 220 cubic feet per minute of airflow each. They're rated at 5300 RPMs, about 68 decibels. They will definitely move some air. In fact, probably so much so that if I didn't put two or three layers of filtering in front of it, it would probably actually suck the spray from the airbrush into it. They're pretty freaking wicked when they're fired up. But anyway, I'll be compiling more video as I go along, as I get more parts of it built. Okay, this is the back of the box here, and as you can see, I got my three server fans there. And basically my plan is to put this box over the fans. This box will encase the fans, and it'll all be fastened down eventually, and I'll take silicone caulking and caulk all these lines and the edges and stuff up so it's all you know, airtight, and then the fumes and stuff will vent out the back of this through a 4-inch dryer tube, which will go out the back of the window. So as I get more completed, I'll put more video up and show you guys. Here we see, I took a PC power supply and modded it to power my three server fans for my spray booth. And basically, what I did was if you look at the back here, I snipped all the wires off. Basically, I'm using the 12 volt leads off of the CPU power supply. I got one lead for each fan, and then I got one ground for each fan, using 3.5 inch 3.5 inch bullet connectors to plug them in. And I've added an on-off switch here to the top and an LED there on the side. The fan's really quiet. It actually doesn't even move a lot of air, so I decided to add the LED to make it to where I can see when it's off and on. The light on the LED actually doesn't light up because this is a 12 volt switch, and the on-off wire for the power supply is not a 12 volt switch, or not 12 volt wire, so it won't light the switch, but the switch works to turn it off and on. And I will be back to show you all three fans running, powered by this power supply. Before I get started with the fan demo, I thought I would just come back and do a quick shot of the top of this after, you know, I mounted the casing down to encase the three server fans, and I've added a dual layer of caulking, you know, on all the seams. I tested it earlier. It seems pretty airtight. There's a couple places I want to check more thoroughly once I get it actually hooked up to the window. But that's basically how it acts, or how it looks. This plastic, basically what I had to do to get this the right dimensions, I had to take two plastic boxes, cut the ends off of them, screw them together just to kind of hold them in place. And then basically The boxes were rather flimsy. I ended up terribly flimsy, but for as much airflow as they're holding back, they're kind of flimsy. So I really went overboard with the fasteners. I got four on each of the long sides, and I got two on the short sides. The short sides were internal because I ran out of room out here to mount them, which was real tricky, actually, to get that all done, but wasn't terrible. So anyway, let me hook it all up and then I'll show you guys the thing in action. Okay, and we're back with a look at the inside of the box before the filters. I will have at least a two-stage filter, if not three. I haven't decided yet which one I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try two first. If there still seems to be plenty of airflow, I might go with a three. If no paint's getting through, though, I'll probably just stay with two. So anyway, I'm gonna fire this thing up here. There's the power supply. I'm gonna fire this thing up here and show you what kind of suction this thing can do. This is a paper towel that's been folded up four times and taped together with masking tape on three of the sides to hold it together. I'll show you how much suction one of these fans has. So here we go. If that doesn't have enough suction, I don't know what would. Anyway, I'll be back with more after I get the filters and stuff installed. We're back. I thought I would just give you guys one more demonstration of how much air is being output out the back of this flange. I'll show you one regular paper towel just kind of dropped in front of it, and then I'll show you the taped up paper towel. Not sure what else I can do to really show you how much airflow is being created here. It's much more impressive in person than I'm sure it probably will be on video, but you get the idea.